Thanks for hanging out, everyone. It is Andrew here, and I'm pretty excited because we recently put in a pantry into our house. And in part of that, I wanted to be able to put in some really nice smart lighting, stuff that I can control via HomeKit and Siri, or for anyone else, Alexa and Google Assistant, all that kind of stuff. So I turned to Philips Hue. But as I was doing research, it looked like there was not a lot of information around the latest generation of the Philips Hue Lightstrip. So the newest version is called the Philips Hue Lightstrip Plus, and the newest version is one that includes Bluetooth support as well. It's usually known around as the V4 model with the micro set of the pins on the end. So while I was working on that cabinetry, I looked into that and did a lot of research. Again, not a lot of information about it was out there. So in this video, I'm going to talk about what we built our pantry and how we installed these Hue light strips and how I not only extended them, putting a large extension in between two areas that are not lit and what we used to do that, the cat cable we used to do that. And then we're also going to talk about how we split the light strips. So I took, you know, one main controller and then split it into two light strips and controlled two completely separate parts at the same time. I felt like there wasn't a lot of information out there, so that's what we're going to talk about in this video. It's kind of a lot of stuff, so hopefully you guys stick around. Let's go ahead and talk about it. So in our house, we literally had no pantry. So all of our food was just going on these shelves that we put into our dining room, and it did not look great. I hated it. My wife hated it. It wasn't really what we were going for. So I decided to build a pantry. So I set off working with my grandfather and a little bit with my dad to build this really amazing pantry. You can see all the photos, the progress photos here in the video. It came out absolutely amazing. But I wanted to put lights in on the left-hand cabinets as well as the right-hand cabinets. I wanted to hide those lights, so we put in that frame in front of the bookshelves there that I would be able to hide the lighting behind. And there was a couple of challenges that we had to face. So one, I had to figure out if I'm going to be putting a bunch of light strips in and kind of extending them the traditional route, like actually going like the official way of doing things, which would mean I need to buy at least two light strips, one for the left cabinets and one for the right cabinets, and then I'd have to figure out somehow to run them across the tops. Probably just have to either run lights there and curve them around the corners, which I wouldn't love the look of, or something like that. So I had to figure out how to gap the tops of the bookshelves so they weren't lit up and they looked nice, and then I had to figure out how to bridge my ones on the left to the ones on the right, or split it into two so I could use one controller to control everything all at the same time. And that's exactly what I ended up doing. So we got the woodworking finished on the cabinets and the shelving and everything else, and we set out on how to handle the light strips. Everything I really found out there for soldering and everything like that was really focused around the Lightstrip Plus V3, and not a ton about the newest ones, the V4, which have the micro pins on there. And they're really close together, which makes soldering super difficult. But the latest generation also has a feature that made it super clutch for what we're going to do. And the way that we did this really didn't involve voiding any warranties or doing anything weird. It was all very easy to do. So that feature is the ability to extend your light strip using a little clip. Now, there are third-party ones like Litcessory and other shady ones on Amazon that had these clips before for the V3 and earlier, but the new V4 just came right in the box, and it actually had little pins on there right where you could actually contact points where you could clip these guys on there and make it work. But we still needed to figure out how to split it and extend it and stuff like that, and how to use your non-official parts. So I did that. So what did I use to split and extend my light strips? I used a big old box of this Cat 5E cable. Now, I tried some Cat 6 cable, and the problem there was that it actually had braided cables inside, which made it a whole pain in the butt. So I would not recommend using like the braided, individual braided cables. We were actually using this, which is single cables inside of the 8 strands that are inside the Cat cable. So there are 8 strands total, and we're gonna need 6 of those to make our jump and our split. To do this, all you need to do is take your original light strip, and on the end, you see where that little cutoff point is. So we're going to trim it to that length because we're going to be using our clip. And that clip is then going to connect to our Ethernet cable. So we trimmed it back on one side. Make sure you leave that rubber coating around there. It does need just to slide in, and those contact points should line up perfectly. So leave that coating on there, but trim it to size and then slide it into the clip on one side. On the other side of the clip, we are going to feed in our 6 cables. So I just pulled back the casing on our cat cable and I pulled out the six strands I needed. I cut off the orange, didn't use the orange one, just got those out of the way. And I untwisted the other ones and just pulled back the casing around each of those into one. So there was a little bit of the wire exposed. So just strip those back a tiny bit so they fit into the clip. You don't want to strip them too much because if there's any extra exposed, you don't want them to kind of bridge against one another. So try to keep them as tight as you can, just the perfect length to fit into the clip. So we trimmed all of ours out. I do want to say that I tinned the tip of these, made them a little bit tighter and fit a little bit better, but it's probably not necessary. So if you don't want to use your soldering iron to tin all those tips, don't worry about it. They should be able to fit in okay. But then we slid them all in. For me, I went solid, stripe, solid, stripe, solid, stripe, brown, green, blue, I believe are my colors all the way through. So I just slid those in to the other side. Now, something important to note is when you close that, it's not going to work. It straight up won't, and I spent a lot of time trying to figure out why, and that's because those clips do need some pressure on the side where your Ethernet cables are connected. So I just took a piece of electrical tape, rolled it up into a little flat piece, and slid it in there, and then closed it down. That applied the necessary pressure to push those pins down, making contact with our Ethernet cables that were locked into the clip. Now that our Ethernet cables are locked into that clip, they've essentially extended my light strip. So I can run that as long as I need to. So I ran, in my case, I ran about 8 feet across the other side of the pantry, but you could run it across the other side of a room, across the underside of cabinets, whatever it is you need to do to extend your light strip. Could be just a foot, it doesn't matter. You know, I used a foot or 2 feet across the tops of each of my cabinets there, my bookshelves in the pantry area. So you can do shorter distance, longer distance, whatever you need to do. You can just go up to 32 feet, I believe, of lit portions. Just take that into note. Now, if you want to split your cable, you can do this as well. So this is what I did to jump from the left side to the right side. So a portion of the way down, I opened up the cable and removed the casing on the cat cable. Again, discarded the orange portion because we weren't using those colors. And I untwisted each of the other ones and I just kind of stripped a little part out with my knife and I wrapped the cables around and I pulled out my soldering iron and just applied a little bit of solder into each of those. So that way the wrap and the cable and everything were all nice and snug together, making good contact. Then I individually wrapped each of those with some electrical tape before kind of wrapping the whole bundle together. So essentially I just kind of spliced on all the matching colors right into the middle of the cable where I needed to split it off. So I basically had my light strip coming up, I bridged it over to go down the other side of my cabinet, and then I also went to the other side to reach the right-hand side of our pantry, and I just ran those down. Now, how do you connect that cat cable to your light strips? It's pretty awesome, guys. You just plug it in. Yeah, keep the wires in the same order, so mine, brown, brown stripe, green, green stripe, blue, blue stripe, and I plug those in the correct order right into the light strip or the light strip extension that I was using. You could even use the cutoff portion if you had to cut off a little piece before like I did. So you can use anything that has those, you know, the holes in the end, the female connector there, plug your wires right in. In my case, they fit nice and snug. These are a very shorter pin, so you don't want to have them as long as you strip the wires off, so keep it nice and short, but plug those in. And that's it, you're done. You can apply a piece of electrical tape if you want to make sure they stay snug, but once you mount your light strip in, these shouldn't be moving at all and you should be just fine. But that's it, once you have everything connected properly, you have your Ethernet cables plugged in, they're in the correct order, you have the appropriate pressure going on in the clip that you're connecting to the light strip, go ahead and plug it in and you should have light coming across your whole thing. As you can see, I've got light going across my entire pantry. This is coming from one controller and I've got gaps across the tops of each of them and connecting the left side and the right side. It was so easy to do just using that Cat 5E cable. It's very cheap. I've got a link for some down below if you need to pick some up. It's so easy and cheap to do. You don't need any lit accessory components or any other shady ones on Amazon. Just some cat cable, possibly a soldering gun if you want to get fancy and make sure all your connections are in place. But that's it. Literally Hue or Signify includes that little clip in the box and that's all you need to do it without having to solder anything. It's very easy to do. By the way, if you go to the end of that cable, it should have a female connector there and you just plug them in there as well to extend them. Just make sure everything is in there tight. So if you don't want to use the clip, you can plug it in that way too. But in my case, I had to cut off that first part, which made the clip necessary to make it all happen. So what do you guys think? Let me know. Let me know what you think of my cabinets here. Let me know what you think of being able to extend and split your Philips Hue lighting without freaking needing anything at all. If you guys have any questions, let me know down below or on Twitter at Andrew_OSU and go try this for yourself. Let me know how it works. I love the colors and the, you know, being able to schedule a control with your voices. It's just overall amazing. I love it. My wife loves it. My family loves it. It's so cool. Let me know what you think. And otherwise, I'll check you guys in the next video.